TDR Network presents Inspire 2015.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ibrahim, in ayah number 12, He says that the messengers say,
وَمَا لَنَا أَلَّا نَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَقَدْ هَدَانَا سُبُلَنَا وَلَنَصْبِرَنَّ عَلَى مَا آذَيْتُمُونَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ.
Allah says that the messenger said, and why should we not rely upon Allah whilst He has guided us to our good ways? And we will surely be patient against whatever harm you should cause us. And upon Allah, let those who would rely. Right? Because we know the messengers, they faced difficulties from the people that they went. But they said, whatever you do to us, we will only rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will be people of tawakkul. You can do what you please, but our reliance is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises them. Also from the reasons why tawakkul is noble and important is because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us about tawakkul in many a narration. For he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لو توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتعود بطانا. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you relied on Allah with a true reliance, He would provide for you the same as He provides for the birds. They set off in the early morning with empty stomachs and they return back at the end of the day with full stomachs. La ilaha illallah. This hadith is in Sunan At-Tirmidhi and also narrated by Imam Ahmad and others. Rahmatullahi alayhim ajma'in. Also in another teaching of my dear brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. And he says to him, O young man, I shall teach you some words and give you some advice. Be mindful of Allah and Allah will protect you. Be mindful of Allah and you will find Him in front of you. If you have a need to ask, ask Allah. And if you seek help from Allah. And know that even if the entire people and community were to gather together to benefit you with something, they would not benefit you with anything except that which Allah has already recorded for you. Subhanallah. And if they were to gather together to harm you with something, they will not be able to harm you except with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already recorded against you. Subhanallah. No one can fight the decree of Allah. Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt wa la mu'tiya lima mana'at. And this is what we say after salah, right? It's a dua after salah taught us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That, oh Allah, no one can prevent from us that which you decree to reach us. وَلَا مُعْطِيَ لِمَا مَنَعْتِ. And no one can give us that which you decree will not reach us. This is the reality, my dear brothers and sisters. So, after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says this to Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, he says to him, رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامِ وَجُفَّتِ الصُّحُفِ. That the pens have been lifted and the ink has dried. Meaning the decrees have been written. Nothing is going to be changed and no one can change it. Right? So we see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaching us about tawakkul. In another narration he says, be mindful of Allah and you will find Him before you. And get to know Allah in prosperity and He will know you in adversity. And know that what has passed you by was not going to come to you in the first place. If it missed you, it wasn't meant to come to you. Right? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us this. That if it missed you, it wasn't meant to come to you. And that which reaches you was never meant to miss you. Allahu Akbar. How many times, brothers and sisters, do we enter into sadness and some states of depression because that deal was missed? Or that sister got married to another guy? Or that guy got married to another sister? Right? How many times do we say, subhanallah, if only, if only, if only. Subhanallah, we open the door to shaytan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us against saying low, if only. So that we don't open the door to shaytan. Put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, that which teaches us how noble tawakkul is the fact that Allah in His book subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us time and time again towards tawakkul. Time and time again. Allah says,
وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ.
Allah says, and rely upon the ever-living who does not die. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Suratul Furqan, ayah number 58. And Allah says in Suratul Ahzab, ayah number 3,
وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا.
And rely upon Allah, and sufficient is Allah as a disposer of our affairs. In Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 159, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ.
And when you have finally decided, put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leave it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah loves those who rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not those who rely on themselves and rely on their intelligence and rely on their abilities. Allah loves those who rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Donate now. Go to thedailyreminder.org/donate.